any notices?
No, because all the groups have finished for this week,
right.
And then it's just the New Year's Day service next week.
Is it, that's, but that's still it, that's 11 o'clock as usual?
That's 11 o'clock, sorry, yeah.
Well, welcome to you all, and Merry Christmas. How's he been? Christmas, it's not a Christmas thing. What did you get? Anything nice?
I got a brooch from Pauline, and it's a tree of life.
Lovely. Very nice. Very nice. Anybody get anything else? David, yes, David got a book. He's very excited about his book. I got a donkey. Last year I got David, well, the year before I got a donkey, and then last year David got a donkey, and this year I got a donkey. So we sponsor a donkey every year. So there you go, so that's my donkey. So welcome to you all. Today is an amazingly special day. Do you know why? It's Christmas Day! It's Christmas Day! How did we forget so quickly? A day for remembering the events from so long ago that are still having an effect today, the birth of Jesus. So we're going to light our final candle. That's your cue. And as Michelle comes up, let's sing the last verse of the Holly and the Ivy. We'll remain seated. Makes us want to shout, to celebrate and burst with thankfulness. You love us so much and we are so grateful for that love. Without you, we would still be lost in darkness. But because of everything you have done for us, today we are in your light and we are free. We will be eternally thankful to you for everything you did to save us. May we make room for you this Christmas Day and all days. Amen. Now let's hear from the prophet Isaiah chapter 9. The people who walk in darkness will see a great light. For those who live in a land of deep darkness, a light will shine. For a child is born to us, a son is given to us. The government will rest on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His government and its peace will never end. He will rule with fairness and justice from the throne of his ancestor David for all eternity. The passionate commitment of the Lord of Heaven's armies will make this happen. Now then, you have been given some crackers. Who has number one? Right, would you like to pull number one with somebody? Just number one, just number one. Right, then there should be a little message in it. Yep. A little scroll.
We're all expecting to wear that.
Yeah, critic fingers warm up.
This way, so much better than we have.
Right. Do you want me to say?
Yeah, read it out there for me, please. Once upon a time, well, that's how the best stories start, isn't it? Either that or in a galaxy far, far away, or space, the final frontier. These are the voices of the Starship Enterprise. That's how stories often start. But this isn't just any story. This isn't a fairy tale, and it isn't a space adventure. This is real, and we all know how it begins, don't we? We heard that in our call to worship. This story wasn't just dropped on us. It's been a long time coming. And now it was beginning. We sing our first song, which reflects that tale of prophecy on Jordan's bank. Let's stand if we're able and sing. Cracker number two. Right, shall we support it with somebody? Oh, wonderful. Wonderful bang there. That's brilliant. Now, you should have a little scroll inside yours as well. And have you got it?
I've got your glasses on.
No, that's not it. It should be a little rolled up bit of paper with an elastic band around it.
You have to open it up, I think.
No, we're not doing the jokes, Andy. We can do the jokes later. Yes, wonderful. Would you like to open that up for me?
I don't know, Andy. Why was the onion crying?
Why was the onion crying, Andy? Because he accidentally cut himself. Oh dear, well, less. What does number two say, Andy?
Dreams and visions.
Dreams and visions. Prophets had foretold at the birth of this king, this Messiah, and now it was time to tell the people who would be directly involved, Mary and Joseph. Joseph had a dream. He was in turmoil and was planning on breaking his engagement to Mary once he found out that she was pregnant. But as it says in Matthew chapter 1, as he considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. Joseph, son of David, the angel said, Do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child within her was conceived by the Holy Spirit. And she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. So Joseph wakes up and takes Mary as his wife and names the child who is to be born Jesus. Mary has her own visitation in the vision of an angel sent to Nazareth, a village in Galilee. She was engaged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of King David. Gabriel appeared to her and said, "Greetings, favored woman, the Lord is with you." Confused and disturbed, Mary tried to think what the angel could mean. "Don't be afraid, that Mary," the angel told her, "for you have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be very great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord will give him the throne of his ancestor David, and he will reign over Israel forever. His kingdom will never end." So we're going to sing again, and the song that reflects that encounter with Mary, "Tell Out My Son." Let's stand if we're able and sing. Who's got number three? Oh, Andy. Find somebody to pull that cracker with. What does your little scroll say?
"I have a chicken across the road."
Return to sender. I'm not going to do an Elvis impression. So it's time for Joseph to go back home for the census, and this time he's going with his wife Mary, who is pregnant with God's son. You can only imagine how he was feeling. I mean, what will the neighbours say? What would his folks say? The people at the local synagogue. There's nothing in Scripture about the journey, how they travelled, whether they stopped off anywhere, if they met with others or travelled alone. All we know is that the journey must have been long and arduous, particularly with a pregnant woman. That they finally made it to Bethlehem, Joseph's hometown, where they found somewhere for Mary to have the baby. And while they were there, the time came for her baby to be born. She gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him snugly in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no lodging available for them. Let's sing again. Will we sing Away in a Manger? So the baby is born, and Mary and Joseph are settling in to become new parents. But God wants others to share the wonderful events that has happened in the world. So God sends angels to some shepherds, and they get their own visitation, their own message. That night, there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were terrified, but the angel reassured them. "Don't be afraid," he said. "I bring good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Saviour, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David, and you will recognize him by this sign. You will find a baby wrapped snugly in strips of cloth and lying in a manger." So you see, this amazing story has already spread. Learned scholars will come from far off lands and bring gifts, And the story will spread further and further as others hear about the birth of this child, this Messiah. But this story will not stop with them. Soon the whole world will hear about how God came to earth as a child and how this child will be the one who will reconcile humanity to God the Creator. Let's sing. Let's sing something that says that we're to do that. Let's sing, Go Tell It on the Mountain. Let's stand if we're able.
Silent flocks by night. Behold, throughout the heavens, there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. The shepherd feared and trembled when low above the earth rang out the angel chorus that hailed the Saviour's birth. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Was born, and God sent us salvation that blessed Christmas morn. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Go tell it on the mountain.
Who has our final cracker, number 5?
No.
Yay! Right, Rose, would you like to say what it says on your little scroll?
Yeah, I can find it. And they all lived in it happily ever after.
And they all lived happily ever after. We started with Once Upon a Time, and now we've got to They All Lived Happily Ever After. Well, do they? It's all sweet and lovely for the couple and the child, isn't it? Well, we all know that it isn't, because this child and the story of hope that he brings isn't good news for everyone. Some will feel threatened by the very presence of Jesus, and he and his parents will end up fleeing to Egypt. But still, the story doesn't end. And it doesn't and cannot end with us. Yes, Jesus is born. Yes, we can celebrate and open our presents and eat way too much turkey and mince pies. But without us telling the story, without us sharing this amazing event with people we know, our family and friends, well, it could end up just being one of those fairy tales. So share it, live it, and be storytellers, just like all those who have gone before us. Let's tell the story of Christmas. It's a cracker. See what I did there? It's a cracker. Before we go, we're going to sing once more, but we're going to sing Joy to the World. It's a slightly different version to the one you're used to, but we'll give it a go, because that's what we do here, we give it a go. So let's stand if we're able and sing. Lots of turkey, lots of meat pie, and have a wonderful time.